Hello, and welcome back to DROD RPG. As you may have noticed, we actually have a new version of the game that was published just recently. And DROD RPG is going to be coming to Steam pretty soon. In fact, it's going to be featuring a whole bunch of new graphics, too. Mostly wall fillers and higher resolution wall textures and stuff like that. Anyway, let's jump right back into our hold right here. So after reviewing the footage from last time, a catchphrase which I will no doubt be trying to reuse all the time, I've decided that second level went pretty well, all things considered. I think I could have made some different decisions, but it's really hard to tell how they would have actually panned out. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to try and do as well as I can on third level on this early shield getting route, and see if I can get anywhere with that. And if I can, then so much the better. But if not, then I'll redo second level. So let's just get some benchmarks here. I can kill this brain spider because I have enough attack that we did get in the previous level. I see we're immediately roadblocked by the need for this green door, though. But we're going to get 400 health as soon as we get that. So that should be okay. In the meantime, killing this for 100 and plus 2 defense actually seems like a great idea. And we will be able to avoid fighting a mud baby here. This brain mud baby, we will think about it later. I think we do need a little bit more attack. Let's see, we're doing 28. So 130 divided by 28. Yeah, we do need a little bit more, but that's alright. I'll worry about that later. So I guess I'll just not fight this right now, but instead I'll see, Requelgate's already 40. That seems like a lot. Yeah, I was expecting them to be 30, but they're 40, so that's interesting. Yeah, 20. Alright, so let's get a green key. So the easiest way to do that, probably, is not any of this stuff. Yeah, this is 2 hits. Slightly mitigated by this plus 50, but not all that much. So you could spend 20 grekkles on a green key. That's the cheapest way to spend money on a green key, but it means that, of course, we have fewer grekkles. But it means that we wouldn't have to spend any HP. So, yeah, alright, I think we'll go ahead and do that. We'll be getting more money from some mandatory fights soon, anyway. Alright, so that's how you get that for free. Or not for free, for 20 grekkles, but no health. Well, I mean, I'm not going the wrong way anymore. Now I can go around this way. Alright, so yeah, we need 5 more attack before mud babies are any easier to kill. That's actually kind of concerning, but that's okay. We'll make do. So this is profitable right now. This would give us 72 health, which is not completely nothing, but it's not that encouraging either. Alright, so yeah, again, that's the other thing with brains, is defense. That's kind of why I like high attack builds in games like this, is you need attack to deal with stuff like this. You have to be able to kill the monster in very few hits. Having boosted defense just isn't going to do all that much against a brain monster. So, just kill it as fast as possible. And get some decent amount of money back. Alright. So I think we decided that we wanted to do this immediately. Again, because we already hit an attack checkpoint. I think that makes sense. So now I've got defense, and it's going to be a while. I would like to kill this immediately, because then we would save, save on that. So I guess that's probably the best we can do. Yeah, we would need 5 attack, and we would need, 90 damages I mean, that seems like a lot, but we were not getting 5 attack and for less than 90 damage, so we're gonna have to do this now. Alright, good. So we got some of our health back. And I don't think this shuts off any other doors, so now we can go ahead and kill this. Alright. So just for reference's sake, yeah, these guys are actually dropping a lot of money. We're not going to be killing this, but we can kill that. How much damage is this? This is 60 for a yellow key. That's not bad. So this is another yellow key for 200 health trade. Yeah, alright, I guess Greco Gates are just 40 on this level. Alright. Let's see, are you gonna get any easier to fight soon? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we could get 2 attack, but we would have to get 2 attack for less than 35 health. So I guess, again, like previous considerations, we might as well fight this now. I don't think it's worth it to get any extra defense quite yet. At least not until we know what's behind here. Alright, so I guess I'll make a quick save. Alright, so here's the thing about accessories in this hold. You might have read this from the official hold description, but there's no, like, one designated place in the hold where the pickaxe has to be used in order to get in. Like, there's no secret room that you have to use this in order to get to. There's no, like, designated area. So once you pick this up, you can just use it wherever you want. I mean, just anywhere in the hold. And the architect challenged us to find the best place for it, so I'm sure there are ways to make good use of it. Oh, right. Our good old friend, the Brain. So once again, Brain is on a pressure plate. You see this set up a whole lot in user-made holds, where the Brain is just on a plate, and if you kill it, you close off access. This is pretty deep in. This is, like, what, 120 Grekkles? I mean, with that kind of money, you could be, you know, getting a lot of other stuff. But on the same time, there's not really all that much else to spend money on. I mean, of course there is. There always is. I mean, like, this seems like the most profitable way to spend that much money if you have it, because that way you can just get this, kill this, and then get that, and then you're, like, not out of any health at all. So this is, like, a huge health investment, of course. I don't know, something to think about in the future, I guess. But anyway, we're certainly not going, that's all we can do from here. So let's see, if I remember right, yeah, there's definitely, well, of course, any way we break this, there's gonna be 2 mud babies up here, so this is just a mandatory fight. And we've just fought, like, okay, well, we're getting closer, at least. 1, 2, 3, 4. So yeah, we would still need 3 more attack. And you, of course, have a lot of health, so we're going to need a lot more, not that much. We're actually surprisingly close to being able to afford that. Problem, of course, is that these goblins are going to be taking, pot shots at us. In fact, it might actually... Yeah, see... Okay, there's actually more health in here than killing that mud baby is worth, and... Going this way means we could face this way. See, what I'm thinking is, the Gray Man actually has less health than us, so if we, like, face north, and we're facing here, facing north, then we would back into him, and we would let the Gray Man get a free hit on us instead of the Goblin getting free hit on us if, you know, you face south and stabbed him. So it would be, you know, better to take one extra hit from this guy than one extra hit from this guy. Anyway, let's see what's over here. Alright. Pretty standard stuff, really. Alright. Goblin. I mean, that Goblin Biter is going to be a big upgrade. In fact, the nice thing about the Goblin Biter, in fact, is that it does have the same, like, base attack bonus as the Short Sword. So I guess, in theory, if you really figured out some sneaky way to do things, you could get the Goblin Biter and skip the Short Sword entirely, and then you wouldn't even need to pick it up. But somehow I'm thinking you might actually want the Short Sword. Actually, that's a good question. How do you get in here? Well, I guess we'll figure it out later. Let's see what's down here. Right. So I guess you just come that way from some other staircase. Yeah, this is nasty stuff, actually. Alright, so this is going to be doing a lot of damage for a long time. We do not have nearly enough attack to deal with Mad Eyes. We definitely have to get the short sword before we start thinking about stuff like this. And that's pretty much it. It's kind of as straightforward as it looks. This is just what we have to deal with. So, one way or another, we're going to be going through a lot of HP on this level. Yeah, this is just completely inaccessible for the time being. So the short sword would, of course, make a lot of these more profitable. But that was another thing that Nuntar mentioned in the chat, is a lot of these monsters are just intentionally designed to be way out of depth, and you're just not going to be killing them. They're just going to be doing unavoidable hits to you instead. And yeah, stuff like this does give you a lot of health. Alright. So I think we're doing okay. I mean, this is just, alright, what was down here again? Yeah, this thing. So, yeah, I think this is probably our goal. We should, get short sword before worrying about rest of third level. Because this just, this is, you know, he's got a lot of health. We do want to get some attack before dealing with him, probably, but not all that much. Because the thing is, it's just a matter of economics. He does 55 damage to us per hit, and of course anything we can do to reduce the number of hits is fine, but at the same time, everything else just does so much damage that it might not even be worth it. Because you would... Basically, in order to take one fewer hit from him, you would want to spend less than 55 health. Otherwise, it's just faster to just do this first. Anyway, so let's just take a look and see what it looks like if we just go for it immediately. We're gonna need a yellow key, of course, but that's actually all we need, I think. Oh, we're gonna need some more health, too. We don't actually have 500 health to just... Well, even more than that, to just fling around. But we have money. Money is one thing we do have. So, we might as well start spending that money. Like I said, we need more attack, so let us, using the power of commerce, buy some more attack. There we go. And there we go. So that doesn't really change anything on this level. I don't think. No, we still need, 5 more attack before, these are any better. I still think we want to hold off on defense, just because we're trying to save up health, and defense just doesn't do that much for us. I mean, the Gray Man is one of the enemies that we've actually met that does, like, the most individual hits to us. They're sort of, well, I say relatively speaking, they're sort of weak hits, and there's a lot of them, but there's just still not all that much. Getting more attack would do more about it. In fact, I think we actually hit an attack checkpoint just now. But we need a yellow key. I forgot about that. It's just, So 60 for a yellow key here. And it's gonna be 60 for a yellow key pretty much anywhere else. Were there any on the first level that I forgot about? I don't think so. That's 65. No. I mean, unless I want to buy a green key for 30 Greckles. That's not bad, but it's not really what we're after here. Check out these bricks. They are by forum member DesTech. Very nice, very nice. You don't do much damage. Neither do you, but I'll worry about that later. I'll probably just swing by and get those guys later once I have the defense that they just don't do any damage to me anymore. So I think 60 damage for yellow key is going to be the best we can do. So of those trades, which one is the best? It doesn't seem like any of them are actually blocking anything, so I guess I might as well go get one from the previous level, actually. I'll leave that one there just to remind myself that it doesn't matter what level you're on. A green man is always a green man, no matter what. On the other hand, I could just buy one for 20 grekkles, but I think I want to save my money. Or do I? So 20 grekkles to not take 60 damage right now, but yeah, later on I'll have even more defense, so I think this might actually be the right play. Because I'm about to kill a bunch of monsters to get more grekkles anyway. Alright, so with that dilemma, well, not dilemma, there were a lot more than two options there, but with that moral quandary solved, we have actually gotten a yellow key now. So, oh man, we're so close. But we're not going to get two attack with, or one attack even, with less than 30 damage, I don't think. No. Unless we spend another yellow key, which again, we're not getting for less than 30 damage, so that's that. Yeah, nothing else cheap around here. So I'm just trying to... I know this isn't going to work, of course. I'm going to be short, but I want to know how much short I am. So 440 plus 55. So I need 495 health. So I'm short about 150. Which means that if I can get that much profit, then I can get this sword, and from there things should be easier. Because then I might be on actual one-hit kill thresholds for some stuff. Might be able to buy my way back to healthiness. As, of course, you do in many developed countries, but I'm getting ahead of myself here. So anyway, let's get to that. This is, yeah, 40 for 100. That's not really efficient as far as that's concerned. Yeah, there's no point in killing this yet. I just said I was on an attack, near an attack threshold for them. So spiders, yeah, they're... That is just barely profitable. If I can just wait until I get the short sword, then I'll have, well, I'm still not going to be able to kill these in one hit, but... Actually, that isn't going to be any better. I'll probably worry about this later. There's got to be a better way to do this. But it might just be a matter of taking damage for a green key. Or, and then just buying anything. Let's see, how much? Yeah, 38. Not quite there yet. What does the rest of this look like? So let's see, we could get a yellow key by being damaged, and then I think there was a way to spend a yellow key on 200 health, or did I do that already? I think I did. Yeah, this is a yellow key for 100 health. So let's see, I could just, with my money, I could buy 100 health, but that's not quite enough. If I kill one evil eye for negligible damage, then I would get a green key, and then I would buy 200 health, and I think that's probably what I want to do. So is there an evil eye actually blocking anything I care about, then? It doesn't look like it. So, alright, just any old one will do. So, guess I will arbitrarily pick this one. Or hold on, could I... Yeah, actually I could kill this one from behind. Aha! Save two whole damage there. Alright. I'm a pro at this game, you guys. So then we just wander around, we buy that green key, and then we should be good to go. Alright, so which 200 health is the best 200 health? I don't know. So these don't really affect anything. This is also separate, so probably the best one to actually take would be this one, because this one at least gives us the option of killing this Mad Eye from behind if we want 22 Greckles really fast. That's not going to come to fruition for a very long time, but it's something worth thinking about at least. So let's see, I think we have enough health now. Let's check. Because we're going to get, 18. That's only enough to buy, like, 50 health. Well, that should be enough to start jump-starting some stuff anyway. I'm just wondering if, like, we should be making some more profitable trades to get a little bit more health, so that'll have some health afterwards. Let's just find out how much health we have after we're done here. And I'll start thinking about whether I should do this right now. Alright, so 51 health, but we do have 55 attack now. I think that's enough that we can actually start getting somewhere now. Green men are actually starting to be profitable to kill now, I think. How many hits do they do now? Two. Yeah, we just hit 440, so yeah, they are doing two hits. So that's starting to consider, like is it worth spending 60 health to get 15, Greckles. So that's the sort of stuff you start running into in holds like this is, do you spend your health for money? And, that's great. We're actually starting to get to the point where that's stuff. Oh, I must have missed a part. We weren't killing them in two hits before, but now we are. So I think, yeah. So, alright. So this sort of stuff is good now. We're not gonna be getting 12 more attack very quickly, so I think we just need this health now. Alright. Anything else I can kill really easily? Antlions are easy now. Mudbaby is not so tough anymore, but still kinda tough. You just need to build up some money, I think. So I should be checking to see how the kobolds from the last level fare with this new sword now. I wonder if they count as goblins for the Goblin Biter. Yeah, we have more than 45 attack now, so now these are very cheap sources of money, relatively speaking. Roach Queen still hurt us, Evil Eyes also still hurt us, but we're killing them, and... Alright, so I think that's basically what we're supposed to do now. I think we need to just buy more health. Just because stuff doesn't do that all much damage. So, yeah, I think this is just the going exchange rate. Might as well go get that one up there, too. Let's just see if there's anything we can do with this amount of health, because if I can sneak in a little bit of defense before I start killing all of these, just worthless, out-of-the-way monsters, I might be able to save myself some effort. Just because, of course, if we get two health, then Evil Eyes don't do any damage at all. So that's always nice. Then you don't have to worry about the accumulation of that two bits of chip damage. Actually, I probably should have gotten this first. No, but that's just one shield gem. That's just chump change at this point. I mean, I guess we could have gotten this. How much is that? 64. Yeah, Mad Eyes still do a lot of damage, of course. How close are we? I think we still need... No, we got the sword. So, yeah, Mud Babies are not going to be easier for a long time, actually. Alright, let's just see what we need health for, and then we'll decide how much health we need to have for it, I guess. That makes perfect sense. Nope, hold on. There we go. Alright, so two ways to get to the south bit here. One is to take an extra hit from this, the other is to kill this from behind. And we're starting to get to the point where we could take 170 for plus 2, that doesn't seem worth it. At least not yet. Eventually we'll be able to sneak her here. Anything really easily accessible right now. Well, there is the brain. The sneaky part about this is that this does not actually permanently shut off the power gem. It just means that you have to pay extra for it. Yeah, you would pay, you like, say you open these and you open this. Then you would just have to pay 40 more Greckles to lock this door. Then you would door walk onto this and get it. So that's not so bad. Mostly because if we kill this now, then that makes a bunch of other stuff a lot easier. Doesn't mean this gets perilously close, in fact. In fact, we can't kill this and kill this to still get here. It's part of the problem. So, and this is going to get log jammed up eventually, too. So you'd want to do this, and this all on the same trip, I think. Yeah, but Mad Eyes are still really tough, especially if they're brain, just because they just hit us so often. Anything that hits a lot of times that's weak is the worst thing to be fighting with a brain, because now they hit you a lot of times, and the hits are strong, so that's the worst. Although I guess the other worst would be if you fought like a high attack monster, like a swordsman or something, that just has a huge amount of attack, and then it has double that attack. Alright, I'm just rambling, because I'm just trying to figure out what the same way of approaching this is. You just run into points where sometimes there's just way too many decisions to make. Like, of course, there's all these green keys here. I mean, not this one. I think I don't really care about this one. I may actually be starting to hit the point where not investing in some of these shield gems early on may actually be hurting me. Because I'm just taking slightly more damage than I would be otherwise if I made this investment ahead of time. The problem is I've just been so short on HP. I may have to restore to the second level and see if there's any way to sneak in an investment like that, because I'm sure I've probably taken at least like 70 hits by now. Maybe slightly less than that, but it would have helped a lot. It would start making some of this other stuff a lot more practical. But I may just be complaining. So, there's just not all that much health lying around is the thing. That's the other thing with these, really small, self-contained bits, is you always know that you have a very finite amount of health lying around. Large holds, you have a lot of trades lying around, so eventually you get to the point where there's just always health if you need it, but in holds like this, you do run the, very significant risk that you're just gonna pick up all the health that's lying around and you're just not gonna be able to get any. It's all going to dry up. There's just not going to be any more. So I think we may actually want to do this now. Yeah, that seems to be indicated. Because that not only does that get us this health, which we really need, but it also got us 12 Reckless. So that'll help a bit. I'm trying to figure out which of those rooms on level 3 we actually want to do first. That seems to be the way forward. And we want to get a little bit more defense at some point. Like, how much... We would be killing one Evil Eye, I think. We could kill three. So if we got two defense, then we would immediately make 15 Greckles. And that's not an inconsiderable amount of money. That's almost enough to open a Greckle grade on the third level. So where would we be getting two defense? I think we would be getting it by killing a brained antlion. Would we? I mean, that's the other thing, is do we wait? So what would waiting involve? Waiting involves... What? It would involve spending a green key and then a yellow key. And then backing into this brain. This brain isn't actually guarding anything. Nothing gets shut off, so I think that may actually be what we want to do. Alright, so we got the short sword a while ago. Get green and yellow key for third level once west. I think that may be what we want to do. We don't want to risk taking a brained goblin hit, of course, so we'll just back into this brain. It'll hit us for nothing because it doesn't even have an attack greater than our defense, so that's fine. So we'll do that, and then we can kill this for +2 defense. We'll probably be able to finagle some way to Yeah, this is one goblin, unbrained goblin hit for plus two. This is an unbrained goblin hit for a yellow key. So those are fine trades after this brain is dead. So I think that's just what we do. We get a green key, we get a yellow key, and we go in here. That just seems to be the best way to do this. You know, sometimes you can just beeline straight to the brain. And I think we may just have enough resources left in us to do just that. So let's see. What's the going rate for yellow keys again? So that's 60, or we could kill this for 60 for 15 reckless, which is slightly more than even exchange at this point. Yeah, we don't need any health to actually do any of this. Like, that last step there doesn't need any health, so I think we actually go ahead and do this. Yeah. Alright, so that's that. And then where was the green key? I think we were going to spend money on that. Yeah, we don't need money for that step either, so we'll go ahead and spend our money. We already bought that green key, though. Alright, that was the one I was thinking of, so there has got to be a better green key somewhere then. So which green keys are left? There's this one. And any of these ones. I missed this. Yeah, alright. Yeah, alright. I mean, I just did that for a yellow key, so it stands to reason I should also do that for a green key. Alright, so now I'm a little low on health, but that's okay. Because I can do this now. And I got 100 health just lying there on the floor. Okay. That's been done. And, you know, that gave me more health. Alright, so now what? So this is just 400, in fact. This is actually profitable, because this is 40 for 400. So it's like, 10 health per Greckle instead of 5 health per Greckle. So that's actually better. If we can afford it, of course, that's always the question. This is not going to be cheaper for a while. Right, so I'll go ahead and do that. So now we've got our defense, so we'll go back. How are we doing on time? I think we're doing okay. I may have to split the episode midway through, but I think we're starting to actually make progress here. So I'll just go ahead and backtrack, get some more money, then I'll decide what to do with all these wonderful blood-stained riches. Right. That's not gonna be, we're not gonna... Well, actually, it's 56, so if we get one more attack, then we'll come back for that, but not worth worrying about right now. So that's that. There's two more over here, I believe. That's another nice feature about holds like this, is they're all self-contained, so you don't have to worry about backtracking too far to get every single last monster that is now free to kill. There's usually only like 3 or 4, and then you're done. That's all you need to do, is just go get those done, and then that's all the money you can ever have. Alright, so surely you've got to be able to do something with that. I think I already know the answer, but that's the other thing, is if we could just tough it out. If we didn't have to buy this, then we would be able to open up that gate down here. So this is another, like, 40 Greckles to not spend a yellow key. Interesting. But this would be 200 health. Yeah, I think this is actually what we do. So we'll just tough it out. We'll only be able to use 200 health instead of 400, but that's fine. And that gets us, you know, one step closer to being able to afford this, this mess here. So if I can just get, 84 Greckles, that's a lot, but... There's enough stuff that gives us enough health that we may actually be able to sneak our way in here. See, that's just the thing, though. Alright, how much is this doing for reference? Yeah, a whole lot. Jeez. It might actually just be profitable to just give up on this one. So if we kill this, then how are we doing? could just kill this instead of spending 40, and then that's sort of good. Except not really. But yeah, the sooner we just figure this out and kill this, then stuff like this and this is more profitable. And I think that's just what we're gonna do. I think we're gonna just try and figure out some way to get enough money, then break in here, get this, kill that. Maybe not worry about this so much. See, the thing is, if we commit ourselves to killing this brain, then the only way to guarantee that we get this health potion, not health potion, red attack gem, is to spend 120 more Greggles. Or, okay, I guess we could take hits here. And those wouldn't be so bad because the brain would be dead. Then we'd spend a yellow key, get this, and then I guess we'd have to kill this to get out or something. Or we could actually kill this now, or something. But you want to have a green key again before that. But I guess you could kill stuff to get the green key. That the same stuff we would be killing to get this stuff. Alright, I think that's what we're going to do. So we have 299 health. That's enough to give us a decent power base, at least. And how much is this? This is 68 for 100. That's not bad. And, you know, in the meantime, let's just do some comparisons. So that's 86 for 2 defense, though. That might actually be worth it, because that pays for itself in half the time. So that would be... we'd only take 43 hits. Yeah, I think this may actually be the time to do that, because we do have spare health. And, yeah, we have spare health, and we'll be making our health back eventually. It's gonna take a while, but we'll be doing that for the time being. And if we don't get anywhere with this, then I'll, you know, restoring back to the second level to redo the shield will give me an excuse to redo this level in a better way anyway. So I'm not sure where I'm gonna end the episode, but probably when I make it through that series of Greggle Gates. So I think I want to kill this now, because this would be one hit that way. That's going to be like 64 damage for 22 Greggles. That's a good deal, I think. No, I think it might actually not be. Alright, what's this? No, not you. And this is... yeah, so this is take, 57 damage, no, not 57, 59 damage, right? No, it's just 55 compared to 112, so it's just 57 damage for 15 Greggles, and I think that is worth it. Kill this one from behind. This is 120 for a yellow key and plus one defense. So I think if I had the health for it, that would be great, but I don't. So if I'd done that first, that probably would have been better. Yeah, these guys just do a lot of damage, that's all. I'm trading in my health a bit faster than I would have reckoned. Yeah, I think I'm just retracing my steps a little bit too much. Or at least I'm getting a little bit fed up with my accumulated inconsistencies with regards to second level. So I think this is a fine place to stop. I think I'm just going to go ahead and try and do the second level more efficiently, because coming in here with more health, at the very least, would make things a lot easier for me. So I think I'm just going to go ahead and stop the episode here. I'll see you in the next one.